David, we know that creating content these days is becoming very important for anyone. You know, I read this book, I recommend this, or these are my 5 tips, a morning routine, or other things. So for international students or job seekers in general, what they can do in terms of creating that content, and some of them might be very shy or they don't know where to start. What tips do you have?
As you mentioned, content creation has become an incredible means for you to get noticed and to get visibility. Yes, it's a great thing that you can do if you want to have your voice heard, especially as an international student or as a job seeker. So it could be challenging at the beginning, of course, because you might think, well, I'm a student, I don't have a lot to offer. People, I'm competing with all these people in, for example, talking about the LinkedIn platform who have thousands of followers, who are, you know, well established in their platform, in their careers, et cetera. So the first thing that you have to do not compare your journey to anyone else's. Every single content creator started from zero,
Zero
building an
followers.
audience. Zero followers, I'm telling you, right? Zero followers. Everybody starts at the same place and they grow. If content creation is your thing, it's going to take a while for you to build your audience, to get comfortable with what you want to say, et cetera. One thing that you mentioned that I think is very important and people could do, for example, nowadays people are attending a lot of webinars, workshops, meetings, et cetera. If you want to start posting content, right, you can take your, you know, your biggest takeaways from those meetings or those webinars and write something about them. What do you learn so that you are also sharing the knowledge that you got and educating other people who might be benefit who might benefit from that? So that's a way. This is another way. When you follow someone that whose content resonate with you, et cetera, and you leave a comment that is thoughtful and adds extra value to what the author post, yeah, you copy that comment that you left. You post it on your notes or whatever, on a Google Doc or something, and you can build upon that comment, right? It's great because you're not copying from anyone. You're getting inspired by someone's content, right? And you are developing your own. So you can do that as well. Those are tips. The more you do that, the more familiar you're going to become with the process, right? And then more ideas will be generating in your head. Yes, and then it's going to be easier for you to post the content. It is great again because, for example, imagine that you're a job seeker. Everybody's using LinkedIn and recruiters are using LinkedIn to source their candidates as well. So, for example, if I am a new grad, yes, and then a recruiter comes to my profile, David Mendoza, and they see the activity and they see that I'm posting a lot and that I'm engaging and I'm being very active with the platform, the recruiter is going to say, okay, so I can have an idea of what the work ethics of this person is. What are the things that this person stands for, their communication abilities, right? And the, you know, the capacity that the person has to take risks and again have their voice heard and have an opinion, you know? So it can make you stand, it can help you stand out, you know, when you are in your job search process. If I'm a job seeker and there's nothing, no activity, well, maybe if you have a robust profile, perfect. But I think the content creation aspect can help you just stand out and gain more visibility, and especially in a platform like LinkedIn that's still the outreach is organic. You can be more visible for sure.
Yeah, I agree with you. At the beginning, it took me 1 hour just to record myself for 1 minute tip, and I was started at zero. It takes time to get practice. What I would say is that also have in mind, like, make a commitment yourself, maybe in the morning or afternoon, make 5 comments. Make a commitment yourself, make 5 comments, not just likes, as you mentioned, thoughtful and engage. And if you have companies that you are interested in, follow their social media, interact with them. And as you mentioned, sometimes recruiters will notice and maybe they will reach out to you and see if they are you are looking for.
Absolutely.
What are you doing? Because as you mentioned, the first thing recruiters do when they get a resume, if they are interested, they will go on LinkedIn. What is this person doing and how it's happening?
Everybody does that. Yes. And also, I think it helps you with credibility as well, right? And it helps you to start walking a path where you will be perceived as a thought leader in whatever industry you are, whatever field you are interested in. By sharing your thoughts, your knowledge, you learn a lot by interacting with people. You learn a lot about yourself also by creating content. and you develop an incredible amount of skills. So for example, for international students, yeah. It's very interesting when one of them starts posting content because you can see the progression in their communication abilities. So if someone is like, I need to work on my writing skills, I need to be more concise, LinkedIn, posting content on LinkedIn is a great platform because you have a limit yes. of 1300 characters.
Yes.
Sometimes when we speak on a second language, we ramble
yeah.
know, all around, you know? Yeah, and I used to experience that a lot. By writing the content on LinkedIn, you can be more concise with your ideas and the exact message that you want to say. So it's a win in all aspects, as you mentioned before.
Yeah, those are great tips, David. Thank you very much. And for the audience watching or listening, if you have any other tips in terms of content creation, please leave comments below and tune in next time for another great question with David.